Now we are almost done with the design. We have the details and everything. And I want to mention a few points about putting everything on the sheets. So let's start by one of the plans, maybe the site plan. One of the things to check before putting the stuff in the sheet is to make sure that all the stuff are consistent. For instance, if we have the bubbles on two sides of the grids, it should be the same in all the views. So these are some of the things you need to check. For instance, I have bubbles on two sides on the two other levels, but I didn't have it so in level 3. That also needs to be the same on roof, so we are all consistent on the presentation. Another thing is to select the best size for the sheets. So I want to try a couple of sizes. I want to create a new sheet, load, and as you already know, if you go to title blocks, we have different sheets in here. So A4 is close to a letter size, which is a bit too small. I'm going to try like A3. And I want to try one of the sheets here to see how it fits. We can go with any of the drawings. Okay, so it seems that it's a little bit small, this sheet. We could either go with a larger sheet or we could change the scale. On the drawings here, there are no scales. Personally, I would suggest 1:100. So maybe I could go with a different sheet. I can open a new sheet. Maybe I would go with A2 metric. Okay. So I want to delete that other sheet. And see how this one works. Okay, this is a little bit better. So let's also try A1. Okay, so you see we have A0, A1, and A0 is the largest. How about we try A1 now? Okay, I'm gonna delete that one. And I'm gonna try this one. Okay. So for a scale of 1:100 for the plans, A1 seems good, and I'm gonna try not using A0 sheets because it's gonna be too big if you want to carry them around. So maybe we can go with A1 and then we can adjust all our drawings to fit on this sheet. Okay, so we can move the level here. You can click here so that handle shows and move this over there. In this view, we can also hide in view category. We don't need to see the elevation items. Okay. After checking all the grids have bubbles, next would be to check the dimension lines. For instance, here we have only the size of the spans, but we could also add one more to show the dimension between grid number 01 to 08. So I'm going to add that one using aligned here to here. Next, we could also add one more dimension to show the exterior line on the exterior wall here to the exterior side of the exterior wall on the other side. Okay, so I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna go from here. So I need to hit tab to be able to select this line. And on the other side, this is the exterior wall. Actually, before doing that, I need to change this to hidden line. For some reason, it was on wireframe. It shouldn't be on wireframe. That's another thing we need to check actually on this level. So this seems to be the exterior wall. So I'm gonna go from here to here. Okay, the dimension that we have here is a bit different than here because we probably use a different size for the facade panels, but that's okay because no specific material was mentioned as for the facade panels. Maybe I could also add this dimension here. I could add it to this line, so you can click on an existing dimension, go to edit witness lines and add one more in here, and this one goes till here actually. Okay, also on the other side I can select that, edit witness lines, and I'm gonna hit tab in here and just click somewhere. Okay, now it's much better. Also on the other side, we could add one from grid to grid, grid A to grid D, and one from out to out. Okay, so I'm gonna add one more in here, and I need to add one more. This is the exterior line. Okay, hit tab. One from out to out, which goes here. Now let's continue with level L2. Now in this one, maybe we don't need to see the beams here. So I could duplicate this one. In one of them I want to see the beams, in the other one I don't. So I want to duplicate this one, duplicate with detailing, and one of them will be the plan showing typical floor framing above. Okay, so this one could be plan showing typical floor framing above. Okay, and this is the one that I want to see the beams and the joists in this one. L2, I just want to see the floor plan here, and maybe I could have all the beams and structure elements hidden. I might be able to just check here and change this to known. Okay, and then I need to take a look at view range in this one. So this is L2, and how do I do this? Maybe I can change this to L2. Okay, there we go. Now we don't see the beams anymore. Okay, also I want to go to L1 and I want to see if I can maybe copy and paste all the dimension lines, copy, paste to selected views, maybe to L2, okay. This is L2, it's good. I need to also change this to hidden line, okay. So in this one we're gonna see the furniture and everything. And in the other one that I created, this one, what we are interested in is actually the information regarding the structure. So I need to change this one to hidden as well. And I wanna copy and paste the dimensions over there. So Control C or copy from here, paste to the view, and this is gonna be this one. Okay. And so how about I change the view range and change this to look up. Okay, so if this is on L2 and the top level is on L3 and I change this to look up, I can see the beams above, and that's what I'm looking for, right? And now we can add some information from this view regarding the columns, the beams information and everything. In this view, I'm also gonna add some information regarding the structure. So maybe we can start by the columns. I wanna add a text, and I wanna mention that this is a typical column, SPF 20 FE, 315 by 342. So I wanna use annotate. I wanna bring some text, maybe two segments text. It can go here, 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 and this is a column. We know it's a typical, and the information, okay. This is good. I need to do this for the other elements here. The purlins, beams, floor panel, etc., the shear walls. Also, we don't exactly see this here, but we already show the tie in a detail view. We also need to mention it here as well. So I want to copy this, put a text somewhere in here. So it's gonna be the text, maybe the two segment, and I want to mention that information here as well. Okay, we need to continue with the rest. So I added more text in here. We could also work a little bit on the graphics. For instance, if you want to change something like to a field color, we can do it through visibility graphics, VG. I can go to search our columns and I could change the cut pattern from here to a filled pattern. From here it could be solid fill and it could be black. Okay, okay, apply, okay. So you can do stuff like this. If you want, you can change the line that shows purlins to a dashed line. That one, if I go again to visibility graphics, structural, and it's under structural framing here, I can go to it's probably projection surface because it's not exactly cut over there. So I can go here and change this line to a dashed line and change this to black. Okay, apply it. Okay, it also changed the beams, but that makes sense because all of them are above the level that we see. Okay, also like you can do something like this as well. You don't want to show the dimension, but you want to show that this is a shear wall, number one. So it's this one in here. I can go to align, get the dimension in here to here, and I can click here and replace it with this text SW1. Apply, that's good. Okay, I can do the same here and on the other side as well. So I can take the dimension in here. Okay, so this is gonna double click and use replace with text SW1. Okay, so keep two plans here. this is our L2, and this is the one that we duplicated from L2 just to show the structure elements, and we need to put them separately on the sheets. Also, we could have a naming for the sheets here, maybe the first one. So we need to start with the table of content or something, and that's going to be our first sheet. And this could be maybe the second or third sheet, so we can rename it from here. And this is our first floor plan. We could just go with first floor plan. We don't have them in this document. It's something that we are actually adding. So I want to go with first floor plan. That's good. Okay. So this is our sheet showing the second floor plan. Okay, we can put it here, move this over there. You can click on this so this handle shows up. Okay, and hiding view category. Okay, that could be our second floor plan. You can create the third one, another A1. So this is gonna be our third floor plan. Yeah, if you remember the first, okay. And the next one I want to create, this is gonna be A1 again, okay. I want to go here and rename this, copy and paste, so Control C, and I want to rename this sheet as plan showing typical floor framing above. That's good. Okay, and I can bring this one over here. Again, I need to hide in view category here, hide in view category, and I can move this over there, and I can move this over there. Okay. Next thing we can do in the floor plans is to keep the main sections, such as this one. And we can hide this one because this is showing a wall section. So I'm going to hide in view element. Also here, this is our main section. So I want to use hide in view element and this one as well. Hiding view element, and then you need to do the same for other floor plans, for L2, L3, and for this plan.